Hello and welcome to the launch of Planet Coaster here on Theme Park Worldwide. There I am right down there in the United Kingdom. Wait, it's me. Not too sure why I'm wearing my shorts and t-shirt. I mean, it's November, it's absolutely freezing outside. But yeah, it makes it even better for sitting indoors and playing a bit of Planet Coaster. This is the latest in a long line of theme park simulation games that I can't wait to get my teeth stuck into. Of course, I am Shawn Sambrook. I'm a theme park enthusiast from the UK. And I started playing theme park simulation games way back when I was just 7 years old in 1999 with the launch of Roller Coaster Tycoon. I got the expansion packs for that. I went on to play Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, where I got the expansion packs for that. Looking a bit confused there, aren't I, stabbing my feet? And then I played a little bit of Roller Coaster Tycoon 3. Was never really a massive fan of that, so literally throughout the rest of my childhood, into my early teens, all throughout my late teens, and to where I am now, 23 years old, I played Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. I love that game to bits. However, RCT2 does have its limits. Something that has no limits is literally Planet Coaster, and I can't wait to get my teeth stuck into it and share my experience with you guys. I've played the alpha, I've played the beta, and I've played it for about a week now, ever since it was released last week. However, I'm absolutely loving this game, and I can't wait to just share my experience with you guys. So if you do purchase Planet Coaster, this is the screen that you'll first come onto. You've got all your different Steam Workshop names down there. You can see all your different creations, what people have made, and of course you've got your main two buttons just over here as well. You've got play and resume. So play is where you start a brand new game in career, sandbox or challenge mode. You can also go to the resume option just there, and as you're playing Planet Coaster, it actually auto saves it as well, which is quite cool. You definitely didn't get that with RCT2. Of course, this is a let's play, and I'm going to be building a brand new theme park. However, it is going to be realistic. We're going to be going with complete realism. There's not going to be recreations of rides inside this park. It's going to be solely my own ideas and ideas that you guys, the viewers, have commented below on our videos. Yes, we are going to keep it interactive, similar to how we did our RCT2 Let's Play last winter. There I am, looking at all the different options. So you've got career mode, where you can embark on a career in theme park management. You can complete varied and increasing challenges scenarios and see how far you can go. Sandbox, which is what we're going to be doing, where you can start a new park on a fresh slate and let your imagination go wild. You're free to build your dream park with no restrictions. Of course, money's unlimited in that as well, which is great. You then got the challenger mode. This one is sort of manage money to succeed in this mode. You'll then have limited options to begin with until you earn your way to bigger parks. So it's quite an exciting different scenario what you can go with there as well. You then got My Parks, that's where all the different games are saved, and tutorial videos there as well. So you've got your five different options there on your main screen. As I said, we're going to play a sandbox park. So I click onto sandbox, it then opens up six more options. You'll notice five different landscapes there, five different sort of areas to build your park. And My Parks, again, that takes you back to all your different parks that you've built, where you've got them saved. And then we've got Tropical. You've got deserts, grassland, alpine and deciduous as well, so lots of different areas to build in. With this park that we're going to build, we're going to go with grassland. It's going to be a very realistic, very fantasy, very fairy tale style park. It's going to have areas such as like an Arabian area, a pirates area, and that's sort of where we're going to be going a lot with this park. So we'll click on grassland and then it brings up what my park name is going to be. As I haven't decided this yet, and we're going to see how the park sort of plans out, as I mentioned, I'm going to keep it really interactive. So for now, I'm just going to call it TPW Park. It isn't going to be called that when we sort of get this park open, but for now, we're going to call it TPW Park. So if I press Start New, that then takes us to this lovely loading screen. I really like this Ferris wheel that spins round. Tells you lots of different top tips as well as it's loading up the park. Really nice audio on Planet Coaster as well. You can hear it there in the background. All custom audio what they've developed, which is absolutely awesome. And that leads us just to here, which is the start of my park. So lots and lots of sort of flat land to build in with this one. We've got a few bits of hills and things all around the side. But if we look at where the edge of the map is, it's just sort of this fence just over here as well. So you sort of get the idea of where the edge of the map is. We've got a huge map to play with. Also, what I like about this, what you didn't have in Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, was the fact that there's no black box all the way around. I mean, if you spin this all the way around, you can see how there's all hills and trees and things in the distance, which is awesome. It means you're not looking at a big sort of grid all the way around. If we look here, this is sort of the entrance to the landscape. And you can see down here where the guests are generated. So already you'll notice the graphics in this are absolutely stunning. I mean, you do need quite a high-powered PC to be able to run this. You can buy it through Steam, but before purchasing Planet Coaster, I do recommend that you do check the specs of your computer. But yeah, I like how the guests are generated down here in this little sort of area down the bottom. Now this game, you know, is very, very technical and there's lots of different settings to go into. So before we start putting the park together and working out what areas are going to go where, I'm just going to go through all the different options down the bottom at the top, just so you get a bit of an idea on Planet Coaster itself. So at the top just there, you've got your help, all your basic controls, all your different camera angles there as well. Then got your notifications, a bit like Facebook this, isn't it? That tells you all your different notifications throughout the game, and you've got your important ones there as well with the little exclamation mark, which is awesome. Before we go into these, just want to say how it's a nice sort of clean sort of screen. You can look all the way around and there's not really much blocking it. It's not, you know, restricting your view when you're building things, which is awesome. Down the bottom then here, the name of the park, TPW Park, unlimited funds, as you can see there, but it also shows our monthly profits from shops and facilities, rides and tickets and park management there as well. Going on to park management then, just above it, if we open that up, you can see you've got park status open. I'm actually going to close that for now. I use that doing the traffic lights just here, because I don't want to open this park until we've got a good selection of rides and infrastructure in there. Park overview is absolutely huge. I mean, this is something that I missed with Roller Coaster Tycoon 3. I like actually building a proper park and making profits, and as much as I'm not going to be doing that in this one, as it is sort of a let's play and I'm going to show you guys what we can do with the tools, with rides and pathways and terrain, but you can sort of see all your different options here with guests and staff, marketing, attractions and shops, and they all split into different categories there as well. So that's a huge option that we'll get into a little bit later in the series when we look at actually operating this park. Then we go into the bottom section here where you've got all your different areas for actually building things here in Planet Coaster. So my blueprints, this is where anything what you've built in the game can actually be saved, and I'll show you a demonstration of that when we actually get building some attractions here at the park. We've then got coasters, so of course the main thing for this game, Planet Coaster, you know, where we've got all our different rides. So you've got blueprint attractions, so if you click on the ones down here, you've got ones that the guys over at Planet Coaster have actually built themselves. So not all of them have got them, but you can see there's an inverted coaster, there's a couple of different wing coasters there, prototype wing and a normal wing. You sort of see a few different options which you've got there if you don't want to build your own roller coaster. However, if we click onto custom at the side just here, look at all these different coasters that we've got here. We've got launch coasters, spinning coasters, single rail coasters, you know, lots of different rides just there. And quite a few of these are actually going to be a feature in my brand new theme park that we're going to build just here. Of course, all the coasters I'm going to be building are going to be custom rides. They're not going to be blueprints. However, we'll have a little look through some of these ones and see what the guys here at Frontier did come up with. Moving on to track rides just here as well. So we can actually raise this up here if we do have a lot of rides to sort of see. However, again, on blueprints, all we've got there is a boom boat, which is a log flume. Nothing really on anything else there apart from the log flume. If we go into custom, however, this shows us all these other track rides that we've got. So we've got a log flume, a monorail, loving the streamlined look of that, a couple of powered track rides there as well, so vintage cars and a Cheshire Cats. That was always an RCT2 classic for me, and a river rapids there as well, rolling river. The rapids look awesome in this game, so again, we'll definitely put one of those inside this park. We've then got a steam train there as well, again, very much inspired from Disney's train. Love the look of that, and again, it looks very, very realistic. What I like at the side here is why you can sort of split them off into all your different options. So you can look at them all, but if you just want transport rides, for example, you can look at that there as well. And I'm sure as Planet Coaster do add more rides to the game, this will make it a lot easier to select what you want to build inside your park. Moving on to our next option, which is rides themselves. Lots and lots of different flat rides here. Really good selection. So when you hover over a ride, you get the name of the ride, the price, the excitement, the fear, and the nausea there as well. Lots of different flats what we can put in here, and of course we can customize them with colors and even import our own soundtracks into Planet Coaster as well. Again, they're split off with thrill rides and gentle rides, making it easier to know what you want to install in the game. But then going to move on to shops and facilities. We've got some blueprint ones here as well. So much like the roller coasters, the guys here at Frontier have actually built certain ones that we can already pre-place into the game. Again, there's sort of all the different options you can go on there, which they're all very different. You've got your food, your drinks, gift shops, I like all that. However, you can do custom buildings as well, and we can actually build these into our buildings, hence why they've actually sort of quite a simple square design. These aren't really what you just put out on a footpath. You'd sort of incorporate these into the buildings, and that's what we're going to be doing throughout this series in Planet Coaster. Toilet blocks there, $200. I don't know why I've got it in dollars, I need to change that to pounds. You've got an ATM, a cash machine there, a park entrance gate, lots of different things in shops and facilities under custom. Scenery and buildings are actually two separate things here, which is quite different to Roller Coaster Tycoon. Lots of different things to go through here. We've got rock work, lots of planting, clocks, columns, so much stuff to see. It's crazy how much we've got in the game. And again, these all split into the path extras, nature, props, special effects, and art shapes there as well. Special effects is a great one. I mean, you've got fire, you've got water fountains, you've got mist, you've got smoke, park speakers, so much. There's even like electric grids and little Tesla coils, which is awesome as well. So again, that splits into another little option here where you can look at all your different ones. So loving that. You've got a few there as well. What Frontier have actually already put in. So much to see and discover throughout scenery, but probably not quite as much as there is in the building option. I mean, again, we look at this, we've got our blueprints just there, but if we go on to custom, this opens up a massive window where we can get to see so many different wall pieces, and there is so much that it's pretty much overwhelming when you look at that. However, again, to split it up and make it easy, when they've built this game, you can split it up into walls. Once you've clicked on walls, you can then get wall pieces, columns, archways, frameworks, wall decorations, and then go back over to your main categories here, doors and windows, as you can see at the side, decorations and wall signs there as well. Now, I'm not going to lie, building buildings and areas inside Planet Coaster takes a hell of a long time. I've done various different buildings throughout the alpha and the beta of the game, and let's just say it's a very time consuming project, so this series is going to go on for a long time. Like I say, it's going to be a realistic park, and it's going to be absolutely awesome to share with you guys. I want to keep it interactive. I'm going to be asking various questions, what you think I should build next, what are the names of the rides that I should build, and so forth. We might even go down the lines of you guys recording some announcements for me to put on some of the rides, that sort of thing. So but looking at the basic graphics, I mean, look at that tree and that rock, look how realistic it looks. I mean, I was never a big fan of Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 and the graphics, but this combines everything what Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 should have been into an awesome new theme park simulation game. I mean, it looks just absolutely awesome. So that's a little look through the basic features down there at the bottom. You think the trees look awesome, wait till you see the actual buildings and the rides in action. It looks stunning. Down the bottom here, then, really nice tool. You got an undo there, control and Z if you don't want to actually keep clicking your mouse, and redo there as well, control and Y. We've then got this, which is quite cool, to set lighting. Of course, we don't have to have it in daytime mode. We can actually set when we want it to be. So if we go onto this option just here, we can click it to be at nighttime. So if I click PM, for example, 10 PM, click the tick, and boom, then we get to see it at night time. You can see all the different sky, and there's even a moon up there somewhere. Hey, there it is. You got the moon. I mean, look at the sky, it looks awesome. It means that when we build a park, we can think a lot more about lighting around the footpaths and on the rides. You can even get the little park hands to light up little areas. So again, that's something what we're going to be looking into quite a bit. Just going to set that back to daytime. Down the bottom there, you got the weather and the date. And then you've got the change the simulation speed. You can have it on normal speed, speed up a little bit, or have it on full pelt, which means that you can sort of fast forward in time with that as well. Put it back to one. Don't want time going too quickly, do we? And then you've got a pause button down there as well, which quite simply pauses the game. Moving up from that, then you've got a multi-selection. So here you can sort of grab an area if you want to delete something, and then sort of you can save things as well into your blueprints by using that tool as well. Moving on from that, just next to it, terrain. Now, the terrain tool is absolutely incredible. In the RCT games, it used to take a long time to do tunnels and terrain. In this, it makes it so much easier. You've got sculpting, where you can sort of lift the land up and put it down. You've got the painting of the land just there as well, and also water. Again, you're going to get to see all of these different items demonstrated throughout our series. I thought before we go into it, I just want to sort of show you through everything so you can get a bit of an idea on the controls of the game, so you can build along with us if you're building a park there as well. Oh, I do love this rock work here. I mean, look at that. Imagine a roller coaster just going around some rock work like that. It's going to be stunning what we can build inside this game. And then footpaths there as well. This is actually going to be one of the first things we actually move on to here in the game. Now, footpaths is sort of crazy how it works. I mean, it's gone are the days of having lots of gridded footpaths. You can make it however you want to. I mean, you can bring it out like this and into various circles. I mean, you can do loads and that'll connect up just like that. You know, and then you can span off from that as well. It's crazy. And then using that undo button makes it really easy as well to get it sort of back to how it was originally. I love all the different footpaths that we've got here, lots of different ones. Hopefully, again, that's something what the guys at Frontier will expand on even more. Really, end of monthly summary. So every month you get your different summary for what's happened in terms of profit and what's going on inside your park. You've got natural footpaths as well, so these look quite cool. So you can build over the grass. I really like that. And then you've got your queue footpaths there as well for when building the queues on different attractions. So that's all your different options that you've got there as well. Of course, in the top corner, you've got your actual settings, so you can go to your graphics settings, saving your park, loading other parks, quit to the main menu, and quitting Planet Coaster itself. However, if you get as addicted to the game as I have, you definitely won't be pressing that bottom button just there. So anyway, without further ado, I think it's about time we start with our park. As I mentioned, this park is going to take up the whole of the landscape. It is going to be detailed, it's going to be exciting, and this series is going to go on for a very, very long time. But it's going to be awesome. I really want to make it very realistic. And what we're actually going to do first, instead of building the main entrance area, we're actually going to build our Wild West area, which is going to go over to the side just here first. And that's what I'm going to start in this episode just here. However, what I am going to do first, just so I get an idea of where I want this western area to go, is I'm going to put a bit of footpath in just down here for our main sort of entrance area. So I'm going to start off with that one before we move any more forward into the Wild West area itself. Okay, so I'm going to position my first piece of footpath inside this park. Here's all the different ones that we've got. I mean, I think colourful cobblestones is going to be the best sort of option for what I want for my main street style area. I mean, this is going to be the main walkway into this park. It's going to be very symmetrical, lots of shops, lots of restaurants along the side. However, I'm not too sure how I want to actually theme this yet. So what I'm going to go for is the colourful cobblestones for now. And then when we go on to building the entrance in a few episodes' time, of course, I'll have a bit more inspiration once I've put in a couple of areas inside the park to know how I want to go in my main area. But of course, I sort of wanted to put this footpath in first just so I've got an idea on where I can build my other areas inside this park. So instead of putting it in all flimsy, I'm actually going to select the grid just here. By doing this, it means that I can keep the footpath symmetrical. So I can place the footpath in squares all the way across. So I'm going to do that sort of like this. We're going to have it five across. The reason I'm going to have it five across is so when I build the buildings, I can actually overlap them onto this footpath here as well. So it's nice and easy to build footpath. I mean, we can go straight along like this, nice and symmetrical. This is going to be quite a wide area. I mean, we might also take a few of these panels out once we've sort of put them in to add trees and that sort of thing in to make it look even prettier. But for now, it's more about so I can just get the scale of where this entrance area is going to be. I mean, it's not going to be a blatant rip-off of Main Street USA at the Disney parks, but I do want it to have a very similar sort of feel. That doesn't mean it's going to be old school sort of American theme in with the Emporian shop and that sort of thing. I don't know that yet, but that's the sort of feel that I want. A very sort of, you walk through a very sort of big main entrance to get into the main sort of hub area of the park, and there will be a hub, and it won't particularly be in the middle of the map, but the hub will be at the sort of the end of the main street, which is going to be around where I'm just putting these sort of slabs in now. So bear with me though, guys, with this game. I mean, I'm learning pretty much as much as you. The game launched last week. I've played about 35 hours of the game, and I've just built lots of various random roller coasters and things. And it is very, very exciting, isn't it? I mean, comment below what your favourite theme park simulation game was prior to Planet Coaster, or maybe it still is your favourite, even though Planet Coaster's here. Comment below, I'd be really, really interested to see what you guys think. So there we go, that is going to be our big Main Street style area, quite a grand sort of entrance to the park. And coming off that down here at the bottom is going to be my first area. It's going in this side here, and it is going to be a Wild West style area. So for now, I'm going to put in this normal footpath. I mean, it's a swirly dark red path we're going to go for. I mean, I don't want to go with terrain style. I mean, we could go with this sort of natural path for this. However, that's what you get in an actual Wild West sort of movie set, for example. But with this being a theme park, have you ever walked into a theme park and walked on lots of sort of grassland and lots of muck and things? I want to keep it realistic as to actually would be in a real theme park. So I'm going to go for this dark red path. I'm going to keep it three across as we go around the main footpath in the park. Again, for now, I'm going to keep it on this grid style. That doesn't mean that I won't change that at a later point. I mean, this is more just to get a marker in so I know where I'm going to be building my roller coaster. Now, of course, in terms of roller coasters, there is a lot inside this game, as we went through a little bit earlier on, but I'm going to open them up in a second so we can have another little look. I mean, what I'm sort of thinking of this area, I mean, you wouldn't really put a massive B&M coaster inside this Wild West area. I want it to feel realistic, traditional, typical Wild West area with very, very immersive theming and shops and restaurants and a few flat rides in, maybe a water ride as well. But for now, in this episode, we're going to concentrate on the coaster. There we go, I'm really happy with that. So you can sort of imagine where I'm coming from. These buildings are going to go all the way down the side on both sides. We'll have some sort of main, sort of either a castle or a lake or something, a volcano maybe even in the bottom of the area just down here. Look at that, I mean, it looks so slick, the footpath. You can zoom right in down there and it looks nice and realistic. I think for a Wild West area, this looks okay as well. It's like it's got the little grooves in the floor, but when it's all themed and the buildings are in, you're not really going to get to see much of that either. So in terms of the coaster impact, I don't want you to be able to see this from the main entrance. Of course, we're going to have a massive entrance feature down here as well, but I don't want people to see this coaster until they turn the corner. They're going to come around this corner just here, down the footpath, in through all the trees and the landscaping, and I want them to see this menacing coaster sort of over here. So in terms of designing it, we're going to put it a little bit further back from the footpath. I'm going to think about putting the station down here and the lift hill going off to the side here as well. So let's zoom in now. Let's have a little look at what we've got. Okay, so we've got lots and lots of different roller coasters to choose from. However, I don't think an inverted roller coaster from B&M is really going to fit inside this area. In fact, I think there's only a few rides that are going to really fit with this Wild West area, and it's either a Rocky Mountain Construction hybrid coaster, a Vekoma Mine Train, or a traditional wooden roller coaster. I think the best ride to fit in with this area, something a little bit different, what you wouldn't normally see, a hybrid coaster from RMC. So I'm going to go for that. It might be taking me some time to build, but I'm going to go for it. So where am I going to place it? I don't want it too close to that path, but I don't want it too far away either. I also want it facing the other way. So if I press Z, it spins it round like so. I'm going to put it in just there. If you don't want it to be on a sort of straight like that, you can also have it on an angle by pressing Z and holding it in. So you'll notice they've got this grid just appeared here. That's just because it's building of that section underground there, and that does it on auto tunnel. And in terms of the height, as we're building this, make sure you've got your height markers turned on so that you can be off just there, terrain relative or sea level. So as an RMC coaster normally starts, it goes into a lift hill. So it's already selected there, chain lift. You have standard track or chain lift. It's not going to get far on a standard track, so we want it on chain lift. So I'm going to start putting them pieces in, simply left clicking. Want it about 50 odd metres tall, maybe 60 metres. I mean, it's an RMC, so they typically do have very steep first drops. We'll go for about that. So I'm going to lower that down, and I'll show you some of these options. So if we pop that in, and then, of course, we're at the top of the lift, so I can go back to standard track. Let's explain a little bit about this here. So you've just seen me build the lift hill by using this. That's the up button. That is the sideways, so we can send the track left or right. This is to bank the track how we want to, and that is to extend the length of the track there as well. So we've got quite a few options in terms of the coaster build there. With it being an RMC, they traditionally do start with very, very steep first drops. So we're going to go with along those lines like so. That is steep. I like that. And then we're going to slowly but surely phase that back out. That is nice. That is smooth. That is. I like that because it's from 61 meters right down there to pretty much down to ground level. I mean, yeah, look at that, just a few feet off the ground. What I like about this as well is we're going to be able to send our footpath down and do something quite nice with that as well, so make it interactive. So, next up then, I'm going to start raising this coaster up into some sort of big stall turn. Don't want it too intense there either, so I'm going to raise it up ever so gradually. And as we're doing that, I'm also going to bank it and turn it as well. So, doing this very, very gradual. Don't want to make the ride too intense. I mean, that already we can see that corner there, it just wouldn't work. It's too intense. That's a lot more like it. So this will be a very fast-paced part of the roller coaster. It's not going to be absolutely massive. nice. We'll go for that. And we'll lower that down again. Oh, it's gone back on itself there a little bit. Oh, it's so fun, this coaster design, it really is. That's better. And I'm going to gradually start bringing it round. So it's a bit of a stall turn, so to speak, but this will be fast. I mean, you're going to be coming over here with some speed. That looks nice already. Keep that bank in. I like how it sort of pre-selects your next piece for you. Very, very clever. That looks nice. I mean, it's going to be fast, don't get me wrong. But it's not going to be too intense, I don't think, either. It should be just about right. I mean, I am going to be taking my time building these rides and this park. It isn't going to be a very sort of rushed job. I want to really sort of enjoy building this theme park and make it as realistic as we can. So that looks cool. I mean, RMC coasters are famous for their very much unnatural sort of manoeuvres. So I think as we go into an airtime hill, that'll sort of work quite nicely. I think the forces might be quite intense as we head down the bottom there. So I'm going to move that back ever so slightly. Do a slight edit to that, just so it's not quite as tight a corner. That looks better. And then we start to raise it up into what's going to be this epic moment of airtime. All roller coaster enthusiasts out there love airtime. I mean, it's my favourite element to a roller coaster. I could take airtime over inversions on a roller coaster. And I'm sure there's plenty of other enthusiasts out there too who feel exactly the same. So I think airtime is going to be a very important part of this. There is going to be inversions in this, but airtime will be a massive part of this roller coaster. I like it a lot. I'm going to raise that back up again. It's all sort of trial and error really with these rides. I'm going to start to loop round again. Like I said, we've come down from a massive drop, 61 metres up to 31, into a massive moment of airtime. That's better. So let's see what we can do from here really to make this a really fun and exciting ride. Like I said, I do want to keep a lot of it quite close to the ground. It's not going to be a massive sort of, you know, it's not going to be going up anywhere near as tall as more than 39 metres again now. So that'll be obviously way too tight if we go in with that. So we're going to bring it out a little bit like so. And extend that piece of track out. There we go. Bring that around like that. It's all about sort of playing with the game and seeing what you can get from it. That's better. I think it's that piece there that's causing me problems. So we need a little bit of banking. Bring that round. We can bank that even more. Now that's nice, that is. And that leads us to go up into our first inversion on this ride. So we're gonna go with, yeah, that's better. It's all trial and error. It's so much fun, this game. I tell you what, anyone that's been playing Planet Coaster already will know just how much fun you can have with it. You can go so detailed. You really can. It's all about deleting sections and putting new sections in again. Right. There we go. So we're going to go into my first inversion here now. So I'm building up for it. I'm already banked in that sort of position, so I'm going to try and build my own inversion here. I'm not going to use one of the preset ones, but we can have a look what we've got. So you got all different types of things what you could do with RMC. However, that does look very, very nice. And that is very, very tempting to put in, I'll be honest. What we can do with that, you see, is change the size of it and it is tempting to go and whack that in, but I am going to try and build my own inversion for this section. That does look nice. We can change the position of that. Anyway, I'm not going to get distracted by all these. I want to, you know, I don't just want to go in the easy way. I'm going to build my own inversion. So, we go back down here. Send it to the right. I'm going to go there. I'm going to start sending it up. We've got the speed to do it. And then I'm going to lower that piece down. You can kind of see where I'm going here, I'm sure. This is the inversion itself going in. Not too sure what I did there. Oh, it's all going wrong. it's a big trial and error game. It's not easy, it's not. That's what I like about it, a challenge. That's more like it. I mean, that's a very, very awesome RMC element we got going in there. Nice inversion. I'm really happy with that. Turn round and just, it's a long inversion, it is, that one. And we'll go into some more airtime when we come out of that. Yeah, that's lovely, that is. Don't get me wrong, you know, it could be quite an intense section of the ride, that, but that's what we want. Now's the time to put something in what we've got preset on the game, so. I think we'll go straight into some sort of big element here. Not that. A butterfly inversion. Don't think I've ever seen an RMC with one of those. Loads of different things we've got available. However, I think we'll go for a non-inverted sort of section. Wow. The guys over at Frontier have done some amazing stuff there with this game. Now that looks nice. I think that'll fit in very well. This sort of brings the coaster back to where we want it. 25 meters. I think we can go a little bit higher than that. I think we're going to have the speed, to be honest. It's a fast coaster, this is. It's not a, you know, it's been designed for speed. I think we'll be able to get away with 31 metres on that one, and that'll look nice as sort of the edge of the area, the edge of the coaster, so to speak. There we go. So we've got a not really technically an inversion, that. It's more just some very, very heavy banking. We're going to our next elements. What else have we got then in terms of inversions in the game? Very, very nice. That would look amazing in there. Love that. It's starting to look really nice, this RMC so far. I mean, I like this, it comes out, plenty of speed. Straight round. I'm going to give it a bit more airtime now. Again, we're going to keep it quite low to the ground. Send it back over into this section here. interesting different camera angles that you can get whilst you're building. I mean, I like how you can easily change that. I mean, you're not restricted to, you know, building your coaster from one angle, which is really, really good. So I still think at this point, in terms of speed, we're still going to have quite a lot of speed, or I'm hoping we're going to have quite a lot of speed. So we're going to send it back down sort of under this section of track. Making the most of the banking that you can get with this game. That's quite nice. You can get quite close as well to other pieces of track before it stops you from building, which is good. Yeah, loving the look of that. I mean, what a beast this is starting to look like now. It's a good coaster. It's not taking up too much space in the park either. It is pretty much compact. Oh, we don't want a block break, imagine that. That caused a bit of hell there. So again, I want plenty of sort of bunny hops and plenty of air time on this bit. As I've said it many times already, so far this game, you know, airtime for me really can make or break a roller coaster. And we send that quite low down, and we can go into an airtime hill under here. I like building coasters that start off very, very tall and go quite sort of terrain hugging. And this will be a terrain hugging ride, I have to add. In terms of the terrain, that is something what we're going to be playing about with as soon as I've built this coaster. You know, it's we're going to be messing about with the terrain and seeing what we can do. It's not just going to be standing on flat land. Really pleased with that section. So as the ride's starting to sort of peter out towards the end, I do want to get another inversion in here, because I'm a firm believer, a bit like John Wardley always said, you know, that a great roller coaster, you know, always have a big surprise at the end, something what it doesn't just end, you know, it's got something to keep people going, and that's what I want this coaster to have. However, I'm gonna have to start the banking again there. Just so, again, realism. Let's see what we can get inversion wise. See if we can put in a little corkscrew or something there. Not too sure that's gonna work. Oh, there's so many different options. Hammerhead turn. Oh, that's quite nice, isn't it? I just don't think we're going to have the speed to be able to deal with that, unfortunately, else that would have been quite nice. I don't know, we might have the speed, 24 metres. Should we go for it and see if it makes it? Or is that a risk? No, we won't take risks in this, we won't take risks. Oh, the same way, I love it. Ah, that's the inversion for us, I think. Oh, no. I think that needs to be done on a bigger sort of style if we're doing that. Have a dive loop. Small dive loop, maybe. That looks quite good. Might have to change the approach a little bit there if we're going for that. I don't think we will. Let's just go for your stand. I was sort of thinking about this originally, going for an incline loop, but might go back to that sort of option. That's the one. Now that's nice. Let's go for that. That'll be really, really intense as well. An incline loop. Again, with this section, shorten that down a little bit. Some more really nice, tight banking. and air time as we come round to this section of the coaster. Oh, I do love this game. That looks good. I still think it's going to be quite fast actually when we get to this part of the ride. I mean, you know, I don't think we need to worry about it making it over some of these hills and stuff. I do think it is going to be still travelling at quite some speed actually. But I just want ejector airtime. I'm thinking of sending it over the station here now. A bit of a, not really a station fly through as such, but sort of going over the top of it. And then we'll send it round. That's nice. Yeah, I like that a lot. So we're getting to the point where we want to start slowing our roller coaster down. So I'm going to turn that to about 23 degrees for now, just there. And I'm actually going to add a little bit more station platforming just down here as well. So this will allow us to have two trains on the circuit. Of course, it's an RMC roller coaster. We don't just want it on one train, do we? So that should do to about there. Yeah, get rid of one of those. So back to utilities, standard track, and I'm just going to turn that around like so now and start building my brake run before I actually finish the coaster off. Now, Planet Coasters actually come with a very useful feature called auto-complete. If I press that, it auto-completes the roller coaster for me. I'm not going to use that yet unless I need to. This is one of the harder bits of the game, actually getting to your roller coaster to match up at the end. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start building it backwards here. So I'm going to put my block brakes in. And then I know that I'm going to have some friction brakes. I'm going to put them in. I'm going to have two lots of friction brakes. Then I know now that all I've got to do is finish that coaster off up to there. So don't worry about it all sticking out a little bit down this end, because this is actually going to be the area where we're going to put a water ride in the long term as well. So I'm going to add a little bit more air time in, I think, just on this section here. In fact, yeah, let's have a bit of funny banking like that. This all will actually help slow the roller coaster down as well. That looks nice. I mean, RMC are famous for doing these funny little track sections. I mean, look at that, what a great angle for building. So we know that the brake run there is now at 4 meters. Let's see what we can do. See the autocomplete finish it. There you go, look at that, that finishes it off really nice. I mean, am I concerned a little bit about that jolt just there? With it, how fast it's gonna be going, I'm not concerned at all. I think that's gonna come in at quite a nice speed. So I'm actually gonna place that piece in. And there we go, we've actually got a complete roller coaster. So what we can actually do now, look at that, look at all the heights on it, is test the ride. So let's go into the settings. I mean, before we can open this ride, we have to obviously put queue lines in and all that, but we're not gonna go into that just yet in this episode. I'll save that for the next one. Look at that for a coaster. I mean, whilst it's still in testing mode, it's got that the bit of a white shade on it. So let's get rid of that. So we can click the orange button at the top to test the ride. And then we can also put it into cinematic mode down the bottom here, which will actually show us the ride in action, which is quite cool. We also get a POV on there, but because it's the first test, I'm going to just watch the ride go round. So it's climbing up the lift hill at the moment. Oh, there we go. Got some really nice angles. I'm really, really pleased with this RMC roller coaster. I think it looks quite realistic. I mean, that is how RMC coasters seem to look. This looks quite different, but I like that. I think it adds a very focal point when you walk down to the end of this footpath. Okay, so we're coming up to the top of the lift hill. Just gonna leave the lift hill. This is always a scary moment when you test your ride for the first time. Just so you know, you can actually test your ride whilst you're still building it, a bit like you could an RCT3. Oh, there it goes over the crest. Off we go out. It's gonna be fast, hopefully. Yeah, look at that. Oh my God. Mega rare time. Yes. Is that first inversion? Good speed, it's fast. Should slow right down here. Oh, still quite fast over there. Hopefully this inversion won't be too quick. Yeah, good speed, good speed. That's running really, really well. Yeah, you can actually test these rides. Oh, feel that air time, I love it. Sorry, I'm getting excited. This is probably the most intense part of the ride, just there, as we bank you round. Still got quite a bit of speed, hasn't it, when it gets down to the end of the ride here. Air time, straight over the station. There we go, that's really slowed it down. And straight round into the brakes. Wow, that runs really, really well. That is a really, really nice coaster. There you go, got the notifications at the top, look, coming through now. I love that a lot, that is great. Hopefully, the force is going to be okay on that. So let's have a little look at the forces. So if we go up to the top just here, you've got all these different options on the top. So if we go on to testing, it'll tell me everything about that ride. So there we go, excitement 7.46, fear 6.73, nausea 3.47. I think that's a good coaster. It's rideable, which is good. This is good. However, the excitement rating in Planet Coaster can change whether you build theming for your ride, scenery, terrain, that sort of thing, which is cool. And we, as I started to mention, just you can test your ride halfway through. So say you haven't finishing the track. Finishing, does that make sense? Before you finish building the track, sorry, you can actually send the coaster round. However, it will crash at the end, which is quite funny to watch, actually. Well, there you go. Yeah, that looks great. I mean, that's a really, really nice coaster. I'm going to keep that testing for now. And I'm actually going to start doing a little bit of the terrain work around this ride to finish up this first episode. But yeah, look at that. Really, really nice. Straight over the crest. Love it. Let's do a bit of terrain. Now, as I mentioned earlier on, the terrain editor is absolutely fantastic, and it means that you can do some really good work with your theme park. Now, I did also mention that I want this to be a bit of a terrain style coaster. Obviously, this isn't terrain style. There's not going to be a massive mountain that high. However, some of these lower sections around here, I do want to add in quite a few hills, and it's going to have quite a, obviously it's a Wild West theme ride. We're going to change the colour of the track and things in the next episode as we go on to building the station building, the queue line and all the different theming elements around this ride. However, I just want to end this episode just by showing a little bit of the terrain editor. So we click down the bottom right of the screen just here, where we get lots of different options. So we can pull it up, we can push it down, flatten to foundation, flatten to surface, we can chisel away, we can smooth, or we can roughen it up. So what I'm also going to do, I'm going to pull a lot of the ground up. What you can do here, you can change the intensity and the size just by scrolling along as well. So I'm going to change the size a little bit. I'm going to start to build up some hills around this coaster. So literally, you know, it's very, very simple. As you're left clicking as you're building up the hills, it's then we'll blend in all your supports with what you've already got. And this is very, very clever here also. So if I build this up on this side, it will then automatically start to build a tunnel for me. I mean, look at that already. That took 10 seconds. And look at what we've got, you know. Obviously that looks a bit flat, so I can then go on to chisel or even roughen down the bottom. And just make that look a bit more natural. I mean, already that looks so much better. So what I can then do to that is then go on to the spray, and then I can paint it a little bit. So if I want to give it a bit of, again, we'll change the size down here, a bit of colour to it. Look at that. We can again change the intensity if you don't want it to be quite that intense. However, look at that. This is obviously going to be like a big sort of mountain in the background of the Wild West. I mean, look at that, that looks awesome. Really, really pleased with that now. How long did that take? What, a minute? So let's have a look in this little gap down here then, what we can do. We go back onto sculpting. Let's pull the land up quite a bit around here. All about sort of buries the supports or puts the footers on top of the supports. So again, you know, that might look a bit, you might think, oh, you know, a bit of a standard hill. However, what we can do with that yet again is we can either roughen that up a little bit or chisel away at it. Give it a bit more of an effect. And of course, we can then get to add theme in and trees and all that kind of thing all on this. There we go, I mean, look at that. gone are the days of RCT2 where you'd build your terrain first and try and mould the coaster to it. You know, with Planet Coaster, you're best adding your terrain afterwards, you really are. And you can make it look so detailed. I mean, my plan is to go crazy with the terrain around this whole coaster. I mean, already look at that. It just looks really, really nice, doesn't it? Let's add something down here, shall we? I want this whole thing to be a bit of a hill going on. Let's up the size then for this. So what I'm going here is I want this track to look like it's sitting on the hill. Already that looks quite nice, but I'm going to push that down a little bit on the sides. There we go. Roughen that up a little bit around the edges just so it doesn't look quite as natural. That's really nice. Okay, I'm going to leave that a little bit for now because we can also go and add water here as well. Four different types of water: calm water, rough water, standing water, or dirty water. So I'm going to add a bit of water in. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to lower this section down here, because there is going to be a bit of a stream running around this Wild West area. I intend to probably send it through the coaster itself. However, this section here, why not? Let's dip it underwater. So what should we go for? Calm water? Standing water, dirty water. I mean, that looks nice. I think we need to make that a little bit deeper, though, to be honest. This is cool as well. So as you're building it, it already automatically adds the water in for you. Yeah, that looks a bit better. Okay, so I can then add a bit of textures of that. And already we start to see the landscaping of this coaster and how it's going to look when it's complete. Again, pull the land up a little bit here. You can smooth it out on top. You can do whatever you want to this land. You know, it's a fantastic game. The land editor is probably the big highlight for me, and the bit that I wasn't quite expecting to be as good as it is. I knew the coaster builder was gonna be brilliant, and yeah, I knew we were gonna have some like the latest flat rides and things in here. But if you just said to me that we were gonna be having this detailed terrain tool, wow! Already look at that, you know, it just looks so detailed. What have I spent there? 5 minutes just doing the terrain. That was then. We're gonna finish off the whole of this with this same style before we start to add buildings and things all the way around the coaster. So, add a little bit more around this section here. Don't want to put the whole sort of lift up in it here, so just being a bit careful about how I do this. You know what, let's have another tunnel here as well while we're at it. So if I want to do a tunnel, I can raise it up on this side. Bit curve over. You could, yeah, you have a full tunnel though. You could, yeah, that's good though. We will have a full tunnel. But you could just, you know, have it slightly banked over if you wanted. That looks nice. It's like it's going through a big sort of crater, isn't it? I think, oh, we'll just undo that maneuver. God, I love that undo tool. Yeah, that looks nice. All this really does help add to the excitement of your roller coaster. It did make a difference in RCT, in the Roller Coaster Tycoon series. However, with this, it really does make a difference. In fact, the guests will rate your rides based on the queue lines, you know. So, wow, look at that. So, you're going to walk down into this Wild West area, have loads of little buildings and things all around here, and we'll have a log flume or a rapids or something ringing around it. I think this tunnel here is probably my favourite. Again, we'll add a little bit just around this back section here. All about the terrain. Again, I want this section to feel like it was here before the coaster, hence why they put that bank there, if you know what I mean. Again, that's nice. Flatten that a little bit. This makes it a little bit more detailed then. Yeah, see that, that's nice. It's like they've embedded into the sort of rock work to build this coaster. Yeah, I really, really like that. Again, we can just paint that up. Add the rock work in. And already, our ride starts to come together. There we go, you can really get an idea of how this coaster is going to look when it's finished. I mean, this is just the early stages of me theming this coaster. You know, this is by no means finished. There's going to be trees and shrubbery and lighting effects, and we can even do something called, well, some special effects on this as well. As the ride is going round, we can have flame effects going off, smoke going off, and yeah, you know, there's so much to this game, what we can do. And obviously in the next episode, we'll finish off this. I'll do a little bit more of this, and we'll start looking at the buildings. What we're going to do on this awesome roller coaster. So there we go. Hope you've enjoyed episode one of Planet Coaster. I mean, the first part of it, there'll be another video again soon here on the channel. We're going to be posting these very, very regularly. Sometimes there'll be more than one a week. Sometimes there'll be one a week. But you're never going to go a week without seeing one of these. So hope you're looking forward to the rest of this series. Well, the start of an exciting new series for us here on Theme Park Worldwide. And I'll leave you with that. A brand new Rocky Mountain Construction roller coaster that we've started today. I mean, by all means, you know, this is one of my first rides I've ever built in the game. I think it looks good for a first ride. I mean, it's packed with airtime, it's rideable, we know the restrictions are fine, and of course we're starting to do something really, really special in Planet Coaster, this awesome theme park simulation game. I'll see you in the next episode when we're going to look at some of the shops and facilities, along with the buildings and the scenery that we can start to build in our Wild West themed area. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.